Today, I'm gonna show you how to get tons of custom color palettes for your Reaper tracks. So I spent quite a bit of time building a bunch of custom color palettes so you can just load them and use them right away. And I mean, I literally sat down, grabbed a bunch of images with colors that I like, and then made color palettes out of them. Then I had to do all the conversions from heads to decimals, then making sure that every color loaded properly on both Mac and Windows, because they both read colors differently apparently. And I went the extra mile and made a bunch of custom color toolbars for each palette. This way you can visualize all colors available and just click and get the color that you want. So I will first show you how to load the color palettes, then I'll show you how to use them, and lastly I'll walk you through how to set up the custom toolbar. So let's get started. By the way, if you enjoy this type of videos, let me know in the comments or just hit the like button. Alright, first, I left a link with the files in the description below. You can grab it for free by entering $0 in the amount. But if you like this and you want to support this Reaper Tips project, that will help a lot. I'm currently working on a website with a bunch of Reaper Tips that will later be translated into an app. It's a super cool idea, but it needs funding for the development. Now back to the thing. Once you have the files, I included a bunch of RPPs so you can preview how each color looks. Each theme shows the color a bit different, so it's good to load them all and see which one you like. One way to open them all is by going into Reaper, File menu, then Open, then select all projects and just check Open in the new tab and click Open. Each project is exactly named like the color palette file I included. So for example, if you like the saturated colors, the color file will also be named saturated. Now, to load this color in Reaper, you need the SWS extension. So just go to the website and install it. It's pretty easy. So once you have the SWS extension, just go to the actions menu, type color management, then just click on load color set from file. And in here, just load the palette that you like. In this case, let's go with the saturated one. Now, whenever you right-click, is this recording? Yeah, it is. Now, when you right-click on a track, under track color, you will have an SWS color menu with all the custom colors and a few cool actions. You can choose your color from here, but that's too many steps. The way I like to do it is just by going to the actions menu, typing custom color track, and then setting up a shortcut with all these. I currently have this map on my numpad, so whenever I press 1 or 2 or 3 or whatever number, I get the color that I want. This way is pretty cool because eventually you build some muscle memory and you know exactly where each color is. Now, if you prefer to see these colors in a toolbar, which is pretty cool too by the way, I made toolbars for each of these palettes, but this one requires a bit of a setup. So I'm gonna now go over the steps to set this toolbar up, and it's actually just 3 steps, but they need to be followed in order. So keep that in mind. Step 1. In Reaper, go to the Options menu, then click on Show Reaper Resource Path. Now, you will notice in the download file I gave you, there's a folder called Toolbar Icons. I named them exactly like the palettes, so you can just pick the one you like. So let's say I want to use the Muted palette. I will go to the Toolbar icon with the folder name Muted. Now, just copy the content inside this folder and paste them into Reaper's folder, data, toolbar icons, right in here. Awesome. Now, don't worry about changing your mind later. You can easily just copy and replace these toolbar icons with the other palettes that you like. All the icons will get replaced with the proper color. Step 2. Go to Reaper, then in the actions menu, press key map. Then import the shortcut key map. In here, you're gonna load the key map file that is included in the files that I gave you. In the same actions menu, click on the menu editor and then go to the floating toolbar 2 in the drop-down list. Now, keep in mind that what you're about to import will replace whatever it is in your toolbar 2. So if you had some stuff in here, check out the description for a quick solution. Now, all we need to do is press import and load the menu set file that is included in the files I gave you. Once you do that, all icons should appear like this. Now, to bring up this toolbar, just press F and it should appear right here under toolbar 2. Now, you can use this button to load the palette if you don't already have it, and you can do whatever you want with this toolbar. You can right click and place it at the top of the main window, or you... Alright, as I'm editing this, I realized that I went over way too fast, and I think this is a very cool Reaper feature. You can pretty much right click and position it anywhere. So it can be at the top of the main window like this, and it will show up right here. or you can put it back to the Docker. And one cool thing about the Docker is that you can click and drag and pretty much place it anywhere. There's a lot of places you can put it. One cool place I liked was right here on the left side. I find it's way closer to the track, so it's easier to see. Or you can honestly just bring it up by pressing F and it shows up like that. And I think I prefer that way more because you're not always coloring tracks. So being able to just pull it up, it's pretty cool. Now you can set a shortcut to it. You just go to the actions menu, toolbar 2, and right this one in here, you can set, let's say F as a shortcut. So that way you just press F and you bring this up, which is pretty cool. But yeah, that's it. I hope you enjoy these palettes. Let me know in the comments if you want me to make more of these palettes, because I definitely enjoy making them a lot. Oh, and make sure to follow me on Instagram. That's where I've been pretty much uploading Reaper tips for quite a long time now. And I hope you have a wonderful day. Goodbye.